Good evening, children. Today I am going to do a maths lessons for the grade 5 students, right? Last week we talked about fractions. So this lesson also very familiar with the fractions lesson. So children, that if you subscribe my YouTube channel Amila Academy, that you can get the videos immediately that if I release to the internet, right? And remember to click the bell icon. Okay children, today we are going to do the lessons of decimal numbers, right? So if we consider, you need to learn the decimal numbers in grade 6, grade 7 and until O level class. But for your level, that some amount of knowledge need of these lessons. So I am going to do the lessons today for you according to the your level, right? Now, decimal numbers. So, you know that using the counting frame or abacus, we can represent a number, right? So, this is a counting frame. This is a counting frame, right? And we can call abacus also. So this place is unit place, and this one we call tens place, right? This is hundreds place. This is thousand place, right? Like that, this is 10,000 place. So if I use the short form, unit place, tens place, hundred place, thousand place, 10,000 place. So every digit in a number has a place, right? So if we write 2089, so 9 is the digit in the unit place. So we need to draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 beads we need to put into the unit place, this string. So the tens place number is 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? So 8 beads we need to put into this string. So here 100 place, there are no any number. So digit is 0, that means no any number. So no need to put any beads into the 100 place string. And here the thousands place digit. So you can draw 2 beads. So this is that if you are given the number, this is the way that number we can put into the counting frame or abacus. So if we talk about, this is a whole number, and if we talk about decimal numbers, that decimal point will come here. Decimal point will come here. So from here to here, if I spread this line, these are the places for the decimal digits, right? So here we call 1/10, 1/100, 1/1000, like that we can name the strings, right? So 1/10, here this place we call first decimal place, right? So tens, here hundreds, here thousands, like that we can say according to the powers of 10, right? Here we can say according to the 1/10 powers, right? So this line we call the first decimal place, second decimal place, third decimal place, fourth decimal place, like that. So if I add some 2 numbers here, 2 and 8. So in the first decimal place, that means 1 upon 10. So there are 2, that means you need to draw 2 beads, right? And 1 upon 100, this is hundredths place. So the second decimal place, there are 8. That means here you need to draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I use a big number, but I need to explain how to represent a decimal number in a counting frame, in an abacus. So here if I use that the numbers here, ones place, tens place, hundred place, thousand place, like that we can write. So if I use the numbers for that strings after the decimal point, I need to use 1 upon 10, 1 upon 100 and 1 upon 1000, right? So this, in this number, this part we call whole number, right? And after the decimal point, these numbers we call decimal numbers. So when we say this number, here we can call 2089. Here, 0.28. So after the decimal point, we need to name the digits or the numbers separately. So here, 2089.28. So a big number I use, and I represented that number in a counting frame or an abacus. I think you got an idea, but I am not going to big numbers, right? Let's write some decimal numbers. Right? Right. So here some example for the decimal numbers. How to name these decimal numbers? So you are given some such decimal numbers and you are asked to name the decimal numbers. So the first one we can call 0.1, 0.1. Here 2.56, 2.56. This number 24.029, 24.029. Here 1251.012001. So in this example, you need to remember this side. We name the numbers we know, but after the decimal point, you need to separately name the digits, right? 1251.012001. Here 24.029. So here after the decimal point, I name the numbers one by one, right? Remember that one. So 0.1, 2.56, 24.029, 1251.012001. I think you realize how to name the decimal numbers, right? Now let's go to the next step. You are given fractions here, 1 over 10, right? Then 25 or upon 100, third one, 26 upon 1000. So I use 10, 100 and 1000. You are given fractions. So how to convert these fractions into decimal? Remember this one. Here, in the 10, there is 1 0. In the 100, there are 2 zeros. In the 1000, there are 3 zeros. On the 10,000, there are 4 zeros. Right? So, this is a shortcut. In the 10, there is 1 0. Then, here the decimal point, it will come passing one digit. So here if we consider the decimal point, it will jump 1 point front. So here 1 upon 10 we can write as a decimal 0.1. Remember, if this 10 power there is a 1 zero, that means after the decimal point, that this decimal point of the numerator will jump 1 number pass into the front. So here 1 means 1 is a whole number. So here the decimal point. So this decimal point comes front, passing 1 digit. Right? Here in the 100 you can see 2 zeros. Then decimal point is here. Then 1, 2. To this place, this decimal point will come. Then we can write this 0.25. So here there are 2 zeros. Then if we write these fractions in decimal, so after the decimal point, there are 2 numbers. There are 2 decimal places. If there is a 10, you can remember like this. After the decimal point, there is 1 decimal place. So here the 100, there are 2 zeros. Then after the decimal point, there are 2 decimal places. First decimal place, second decimal place, right? So here thousands you can see. So in the thousands, there are 3 zeros. Then the decimal point is here. Then 3 times need to jump to the front this decimal point. So 1 jump, second jump, another jump. So here is the decimal point. So there are no numbers. Then you can put the 0. Then this one we can write as in a short way 0.026. Right? So in the thousand there are 3 zeros, and after the decimal point there are 3 decimal places. 1, 2, 3. So if we 26 upon 1000, if we convert into fractions, we can call 0.026. Right? Here in the numerator, there are the number in the numerator 26. There are no 3 numbers. That's why if it come front 3 times, I can use 0 here. So in 10,000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 zeros are there. Then if we consider the numerator, 1256, then the decimal point is here. Then 4 zeros, that means 4 times need to come the decimal point to the front. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then here should be the decimal point. So in a shortcut way, we can write 0.1256, right? So I think you realize the shortcut method. So here 10 is there, then the decimal point of the numerator come 1 time front. So here 100 is there, there are 2 zeros, then the decimal point of the numerator jump 2 times to the front. Here the power of 10 is, that means 3, that means 1000. So 3 zeros are there. So here the decimal point of the numerator, it will jump 1, 2, 3 times to the front. And here 10,000, there are 4 zeros. Then the decimal point is here. So that decimal point will jump 1, 2, 3, 4 times to the front. So this is a shortcut method. But children, that these answers you can get if you go to the long division. So this is a fraction, and this number we call the numerator, this one we call the denominator, we learned in the last week. So if you go to long division, you can get this answer. So 1 is the dividend, 10 is the divisor. So if we consider how many tens are there per 1, no, so we can put the 0. Then 0 times 10 is 0. Get the balance 1. Then there are no any digit to take to this place. Then you can keep the decimal point here. If you keep the decimal point, you can put a 0 here. Then what is the number made? 10. How many tens are there for 10? 1. So 1 times 10 is 10. Then if we get the balance, that 0 will come as the remainder. So if we go to the long division, we can take this answer. Answer is 0.1. So 1 upon 10, that fraction, we can write as a decimal number 0.1. Okay, children? But here, a shortcut method. There is a 1 0, then decimal point of the numerator will come 1 time front. I think you realize. Let's go to another 2 example. Right? So here, 28 upon 25. Let's consider this one. So here you can see denominator is not a power of 10. It is not a power of 10. But if you consider the knowledge you got about equivalent fraction, you can convert this denominator, you can write this denominator as a power of 10. So here 25 into 4, then the numerator also I need to multiply by 4, right? Then 25 into 4 is 100, right? So 28 times 4, 4 times 8 is 32, 3 is there. 4 times 2 is 8, 8 plus 3 is 11. So if we multiply 28 by 4, the new numerator will come as the 112. And if we multiply 25 by 4, the new denominator will come as 100, right? So you need to consider, here 25 is there, if you get the knowledge and memory of the multiplication table, you feel that 425 is 100, right? So here 100 is there. So in the 100 there are 2 zeros. Then now in the numerator decimal point is here. Then there are 2 zeros. That means this decimal point need to jump two times. So 1, 2. Then here should be the decimal point. So 112 upon 100 we can write as 1.12. I think you realize this method. This is the shortcut method. In the maths, you need to learn very shortcut method, not time taken methods. But I said to you that if you go to the long division, you can get that answer. Let's go to the long division. Here, 28 is the dividend and 25 is the divisor. How many 25s are there for 28? 1. 1 into 25 is 25. If you get the balance, 8 minus 5 is 3. 3 will come. So there are no any other digits to take to this place. Then you can put the decimal point. Then you can write 0. How many 25s are there for 30? 1. 1 times 25 is 25. Then what is the balance? 5. Already, if we have put the decimal point here, we can write another 0. So, how many 25s are there for 50? 2. 2 into 25 is 50. Then the balance is 0. So, if I go to the long division, the answer has come 1.12. So, 28 upon 25, that fraction, if you go to the long division, we can easily write it in decimal numbers. But you learn this shortcut method. You learn this shortcut method, right? So let's go to another one. Right here, look at this one. 2 upon 20. So 20 we can write as 100 if we multiply it by 5. So the numerator also needs to multiply by 5. Then 2 times 5 is 10. 20 times 5 is 100. So 10 upon 100. So in the denominator, there are 2 zeros. Then in the numerator, decimal point will jump to the front 2 times. Here 1 and 2. then this we can write 0 point, here should be the decimal point, 0.10. This is the answer. Shortcut method. But if you go to the long distance, 2 need to divide by 20. There are no any 20s per 2, so 0 times 20 is 0. Get the balance. There are no any digit. You can put the decimal point, or you can write 10, right? So for the 20, how many 20s are there? 1. 1 times 20 is 20. So you have got the answer. So 2 upon 20, if we write in decimal numbers, the answer is 0.1. 0.1 equals 0.10. I think you understood how to convert the given fractions into decimal. So in for the grade 5 students, then you need to learn about how to add decimal numbers, how to subtract decimal numbers, and how to multiply the given decimal number by a whole number, right? So it is easy. You will know how to add and how to subtract whole numbers. Like that way you can add. So one example here, 2.567 plus 1.265, right? So let's add 7, 5, 12, right? 2, 1 is there, get it to the front. 6 plus 6 is 12, 12 plus this one is 13, right? 3, and the 1 get front. 5 plus 2 is 7, and if that 1, if we add, 8 will come. Here the decimal place is there, 2 plus 1 is 3. So in the normal way, we can add, but you need to write the numbers, these that digits in the correct place. So here there are 3 decimal places. The right place you need to write those numbers. So if we add 2.567 to the 1.265, the answer is 3.832. Right? You are given like that sum. So 2.456 plus 9.01. Add. It is very difficult to that it is very difficult to add these numbers, that if you consider like given way in a horizontal way. So write it these numbers in vertical way, keep in the right place the digit. Here 2.451, right? What is the whole number? 9. It is in the ones place. Here 2 is the ones place. So this 9 need to write in the correct place. In this decimal number 2 is in the unit place. In this decimal number 9 is in the unit place. So unit place numbers need to write in the unit places, right? Then keep the decimal point. So the first decimal number is 4 of this decimal number, right? And here the first decimal place is 0. Then 0 should come here. Then in the second decimal place here 5, in the second decimal place here 1, then 1 should be right under 5, not under 1. So there are no numbers here, you can put 0. Now we right here 1, 5 plus 1 is 6, here 4 plus 0 is 4, here decimal point will come, 9 plus 2 is 11. So I think you understood about this method. Remember children, you need to write the given numbers, that digits of the given numbers in the correct places and add. Let's go to the subtraction. Right here 9.75. From that decimal number, you need to subtract 1.24, right? So 5 minus 4, 1, 7 minus 2, 5, and 9 minus 1 is 8. So the answer is 8.51. But if you are given like this way, right? 7.651. From that number, decimal number subtract 3.92. You need to subtract. Right? It is very difficult to that subtract if you that go to subtract in the given way. Write these numbers in a vertical way. So 7 is the ones place. First decimal place number is 6, then 5, then 1 will come. Then this is the unit place number. Write it down. Right? Then the first decimal place number is 9. And the second decimal place number is 2. Then here 0 will come. Let's subtract here. 1 minus 0 is 1. 5 minus 2, 3, 6 minus 9, you can't. Then take 1 to that place. Then this becomes 6 and here become 16. So 16 minus 9, the answer is 7. Right? So here decimal point is there. Now here the digit is not the 7, it is 6. 6 minus 3 is 3. Then the answer is 3.731. Right? I think children, you realize this method. Let's go to the last part. So you are given a decimal number. Right? 0.12. This number you need to multiply by a given whole number. Right? 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times 0 is 0. You can multiply it in the same way you will do for the other numbers, whole numbers. So 2 times 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times 0 is 0. But from the answer, you need to keep the decimal point considering this number. So after the decimal point, there are two digits are there, two numbers are there. So here from the answer also, you need to separate two numbers and you need to keep the decimal point. Here 1, 2, then here should be the decimal point. Let's go to another one. 1.012, you need to multiply it by 3, right? So don't consider about the decimal point. Multiply this number as normal. 3 times 2 is 6. 3 times 1 is 3. 3 times 0 is 0. 3 times 1 is 3. Then if we consider, after the decimal point there are 3 numbers. Then from the answer also you need to separate 3 numbers, 3 digits, and you need to keep the decimal point. So 1, 2, 3. Here you should keep the decimal point. So the answer is 3.036. Let's go to another last example. So 25.1. You need to multiply it by 5. 5 is the whole number. 25.1 is the decimal number. So 1 times 1. 5 times 1 is 5. 5 times 5 is 25. Right, 5, 2 is there. 5 times 2 is 10. To that answer, if we add these 2, it becomes 12. Right? 5 into 1, 5. 5 into 5, 25. Right, 5, 2 is there that you need to get to the front number. So 5 into 2 is 10. To 10, if we add these 2, it becomes 12. Then if you look at this number, after the decimal point, there is one number. So from the answer, you need to separate one digit and need to keep the decimal point. So I separate one and keep here the decimal point. Okay, children, in this lesson, for the grade 5 students that level about decimal numbers, you need to understand what are the decimal numbers. Decimal numbers means it is not a whole number. It is like some parts, not a whole number. So easily we can write the given fractions into decimal numbers if you go to the long division. But children, in this video I told you how to use the shortcut way to write the given fractions in decimal numbers. In this video, you learn about if you are given decimal numbers, how to subtract. If you are given decimal numbers, how to multiply them using a whole number. Okay, children, I think you realize. So, subscribe my Amil Academy YouTube channel and remember to click the bell icon. Then you will get the videos if I release those things into the net as possible as soon. So, okay, children, let's meet next week with another lesson. So, children, goodbye. Have a good day.